Ah, that looks better. No idea what was happening around then. Okay, so I think we were in World War One, if I remember rightly. But I think I don't know if I have to do everything again or just. I think I have to start the mission again. At least. Unexpected toddler awakening. Never really sure when he's actually fully awake and when he's not. Just have to kind of act like he's awake. Right, so where are we? I'd collected quite a few of the chests and such, which. Oh, notifications. So we are. Buzz, buzz, buzz. So, okay, so that lit. Oh, thank goodness there was a checkpoint. Did I get the glitches though? That's the question. Oh, what's her name again? Lydia. Thank you. maybe up the other side? What in the world? Foggiest idea how to get that. Maybe I have to go. Bridge of fears again. Oh, this is so frustrating. Just down. Thank you. Every time. Two seconds. Okay, so you can fall into it. If I try dropping from the other side, maybe. This is a ridiculous glitch. Calls for a biscuit. That got closer than all the other attempts, mind.
Thank you.
This sucks. This is just ridiculous. No. I think I'm gonna have to find a video for this one. Should just do my head in now. Dear Lizzie, Daddy is still far away on his grand adventure, but he misses you very much and thinks of you every moment. I know you wanted with all your heart that I should be there for your birthday, and I wanted it too. I hope you like the present I sent. Hold it tight when you go to sleep, and that way I'll be closer to you. You must do everything Mummy tells you, and must study hard at school and make me very proud, as I know you will. Already from your letter, I can see how nicely you write and how very clever you are getting. I've made a new friend here who likes to write too. His name is Wilfred. And he spends much of his time writing poetry. If you're a good little girl, I will ask him to write a poem for you. Would you like that? With all the love in the world, Daddy. Sergeant Michael Parrell was killed at the Battle of the Somme the following month. does it every time.
It is done, sir.
Let us postpone celebrations. One of the bloody blimps has broken through. Not to worry. I have a contingency plan.
Thank you.
not doing anything.
Heartwarming sight, Miss Fry.
Your remarkably armed boat deserves a share of recognition.
One of my experimental projects when I was Lord of the Admiralty. I haven't always been a man of shadows.
And I suppose this victory will thrust you back into the limelight.
We may have struck a blow against the enemy, but London is still riddled with German agents. Currently, there's a new group, unlike anything I've seen before. Theirs is a fanatical, almost religious fervor.
And you believe I'm the woman to flush them out?
Indeed. I dare not approach Mr. Asquith without firmer evidence, but I believe they pose an immediate threat. If you concede to this, I give you my word that once I've battled my way back into Parliament, I shall see if something can't be done about your request. As you are aware, a vote can be far more lethal than a bullet or a blade.
Really do need to figure out how to get that glitch. Dear Uncle, April 1915. I'm recovering quite well from my wounds, so the doctors tell me. There is still such a thick air of dejection in the hospital, and we all remember the friends we've lost, and in what a futile effort we lost them. Scenes of the... Excuse me? Dardanelles will haunt us for many years, I expect, though I was pleased to hear your news. From home, Churchill deserves much worse than to be cast out of the Admiralty for the mess he brought us into at Gallipoli. If you say he is making plans to see the Western Front for himself, then no doubt his recklessness will bring him graver punishment. I look forward to sailing home once I am sufficiently well and appreciate your offer of a post in Westminster. I intend to do you proud and endeavour to win this war from the officers of London, since I could accomplish so little here. Your faithful nephew, George. Lieutenant George Featherway had a short career as a politician and prospered as a businessman after the war. There has got to be a way to get this bloody in there. Whilst attempting not to swear. Right. Well, I dropped off once and I managed to nearly get it. I can't remember where I dropped off to. Gotta be a good way to get there. Okay, so not. Oh, I can't even. Where is it? There. Right, the leap of faith doesn't work. I think I figured out how to drop correctly without dying, but I've just got to get the right positioning. So frustrating, I don't like this. This is really fiddly. I wish there were a quicker way up. questioning myself on how I actually do like a leap of faith now. It's like it's mega precise. No, I'm not doing it. I'm giving up. Redacted. Lovely. Lydia Fry. Date of birth. Born into relative comfort, Jacob's granddaughter Lydia was initially reluctant to enter into the family business, preferring to concentrate on her studies. However, it was this very education that showed her just how much influence the Templars still had over the history of the world. After seeing friends and family fall in secret battle, she decided to join the fight. Lydia's parents were often engaged in assassin missions across the continent, so the role of instructor fell to her grandfather Jacob and grand-aunt Evie. She became a very well-balanced assassin, one who could carefully assess any situation and strike with precision, but one who could also think for herself and improvise when a plan fell through. Lydia fell in love with a fellow assassin named Sam Crowder, and they were married shortly before the outbreak of the First World War. Assassins from all across Europe were pulled in every direction in order to have a presence in every theatre of war and seat of power. While Sam, along with many others from the British Brotherhood, enlisted in the army, Lydia took it upon herself to stay and watch over London. After securing the Elder Fry safely away in the countryside, Lydia returned to London and worked alone to protect it not only from German spies but the manipulative British right of the Templar Order, but also from any new and strange threats that sought to take advantage of the chaos. Then we have Winston Churchill. Born in 1874 into an influential aristocratic family, Winston believed he was destined for great things from the start, and was very obsessed with eclipsing his ancestors, all very healthy among them, his father, Lord Randolph Churchill, who served as Chancellor of the Exchequer and the first Duke of Marlborough, and won a series of battles against the French in the War of the Spanish Succession, which makes him rather likeable in my eyes. In 1895, Winston Churchill joined the British Army, serving in the Indian Northwest frontier in the Sudan. 4 years later, he left to work as a war correspondent and was taken prisoner by the Boers, while reporting on the war in South Africa. He escaped by travelling almost 300 miles into Mozambique. Oh dear. Excuse me. It was after this that he entered politics, quickly developing a reputation for self-aggrandisement, particularly after his highly publicised presence in a police siege on the streets of London, where he allegedly gave direction on the ground. In 1911, he became the first Lord of the Admiralty and oversaw the modernisation of the British Navy. It was in this position that he was first involved in the First World War, obsessing over how to counter the German submarine threat. Forced to resign over the failed Battle of Gallipoli, Churchill stepped outside of politics to lead a brigade on the Western Front, experiencing the war firsthand before returning to Britain, where he would become Minister of Munitions in 1917. His supervision of the production and delivery of tanks, planes and ammo to the front was credited as a significant contributor to Germany's defeat. It was his role during the Second World War, for which he is most remembered, though, as Prime Minister during the conflict. He was celebrated for his tactical nous, leadership and steadfast refusal to allow the Nazis to succeed. Later, he would continue to shape world events, pushing for social reform in Britain and winning the Nobel Prize for Literature. He died of a stroke in 1965, arguably having achieved precisely what he set out to do in his youth. By the last quarter of the 19th century, commerce in the East End had reached such levels that it was necessary to build a new bridge to support its development. The committee in charge of selecting the design had to contend with the difficulty of late 19th century river traffic, which led to the final choice of a two-level bridge, a lower bascule bridge, which could be raised to allow tall-masted ships to pass, and an upper walkway which pedestrians could use at all times. Construction of Tower Bridge, which earned its name due to proximity to the Tower of London, began in 1886 and lasted 8 years. It required a monumental engineering effort, not least the creation of the hydraulic system used to operate the bascules. Its huge pumping engines were driven by steam until 1976, when they were replaced by an electrical system. The upper walkway was seldom used and became a haunt for criminals and prostitutes, leading to its closure in 1910, which seems a rather unexciting decision, although it gained a new function during the First World War as the site for some of the many anti-aircraft guns installed to protect the city from German Zeppelins. And we read all these. Time anomaly. The time anomaly is an unstable glitch in Helix Steps. Steps through it to be teleported to a different era of London and prepare to face the challenges that await there. One more time. It's one of those where you're just gonna have to be like insanely precise. really the top. Oh, Jesus. Too far back. I think I've figured it. I think I've done it. It's literally the most frustrating thing. Oh, no, the Gatling gun has to be the most frustrating mission. Because that's another one I can't do. I'm giving up for this evening because I'm not in the mood. I'm going to go and watch something. And I will come back to this tomorrow. Very, very frustrating. Says I have one viewer, so whoever you are, thank you for watching, despite the frustration and how boring it must have been, just doing the same thing over and over. I will try harder tomorrow. Bye for now.